Hi, welcome to Real Math. I'm Rosie Jolene Mbintan, and I'm gonna be your teacher for today's discussion, which is about corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Okay, so to prove that two triangles of the same shape, certain parts of one triangle must coincide with certain parts of the other triangle. To be more specific, the vertices of each triangle must have a one-to-one correspondence. This means that the measure of each side and angle of each triangle corresponds to a side or angle of the other triangle. And we use the left-right arrow symbol for correspondence. And as we will see, triangles don't necessarily have to be congruent to have a one-to-one correspondence. But when they are congruent, it is necessary to know the correspondence of the triangles to know exactly which sides and which angles are congruent. So the correspondence ABC and DEF is called a congruence between triangle ABC and triangle DEF if correspondence of the following conditions will hold. First is when every pair of corresponding sides are congruent, and when every pair of corresponding angles are congruent. Okay, so we have here a given. When we want to say that a given triangle like this, triangle ABC and triangle DEF, is congruent to each other, the order of the vertices in the name makes a very big difference. Okay, so if we know that this triangle ABC and triangle DEF are congruent, then A is corresponding D, B corresponds to E, and C corresponds with F. Okay, so that's the order of their arrangement. So A here corresponds to D, B corresponds to E, and C corresponds to F. And also, side AB is congruent to DE, side BC is congruent to side EF, side AC is congruent to side DF, which means that AB is equal to DE, BC is equal to EF, and AC is equal to DF. And also, the angles A, B, and C are congruent to the other triangle's angle, which are angle D, angle E, and angle F, which means that angle A is just equal to angle D, angle B is just equal to angle E, and angle C is just equal to angle F. Okay, so another example, triangle QAF is congruent to angle LET. So we're not given illustrations here, but we know that the name, the corresponding sides and angles by their arrangement is necessary. So if triangle QAF is congruent to angle LET, then Q is corresponding to L, A corresponds to E, and F corresponds to T, which also means that the side QA is congruent to side LE, which means that QA is equal to LE. Side AF is congruent to ET, so AF is just equal to ET. QF, or the side QF, is congruent to side LT, which means that QF is just equal to LT. Same goes with their angles. Angle Q is congruent to angle L, so angle Q is just equal to angle L. Angle A is congruent to angle E, so angle A is just equal to angle E. Angle F is congruent to angle T, which means that angle F and angle T are equal. Okay, so I have here an example. The figure below shows the two triangles with the lengths of the sides in terms of X, Y, and Z. If triangle BCD is congruent to triangle UVT, find the values of X, Y, and Z. So the left illustration is the triangle BCD, and in the right side is the triangle UVT, and they are congruent, which means that their sides are also congruent. So since triangle BCD is congruent to triangle UVT, by CPCTC assures that BC is equal to UV, CD is equal to VT, and BD is equal to UT. That is, 7 plus Y, which is BC, is equal to 17 minus Y, which is UV. So by addition property of equality, Y plus Y is equal to 17 minus 7, which gives us 2y is equal to 10. And when we divide both sides by 2, we are given y is equal to 5. So our answer is y is equal to 5. There. Next is z. So for z, we have z minus 1 is equal to 8.9 minus 2z. So z minus 1 is our cd, and our 8.9 minus 2z is our vt. Okay, so again, adding or subtraction property of equality, we have 7 plus 2z is equal to 8.9 plus 1, and combining 7, z plus 2z, which gives us 3z, and adding 8.9 plus 1 gives us 9.9, and dividing both sides by 3, we end up having z, which is equal to 3.3. Now for the x, we have 2x plus 1, which is equal to 6.6 plus x. We need to combine like terms, so we need to transpose x to the other side. So we have 2x minus x, which is equal to 6.6 minus 1. And now we have x is equal to 5.6. Okay, so when we when we are able to solve y, z, and x, we can already substitute these values to the y, x, and z for us to have the values of bc, which is equal to uv, cd, which is equal to vt, and bd is equal to ut. Again, I am Rosie Julian Bintan, and thank you for watching. Bye!